Jameco.
Hey, this is Ryan, and here's a quick video of the assembly and programming of the clock kit at Jameco Electronics. First, I installed the resistors, then solder and clip the leads. Next, I installed the capacitors, then solder and clip those leads. Then I installed the crystals, mini push button switch, sockets, and all sorts of headers. Not all of them stayed in when I flipped it over, so I soldered what did and used self-closing tweezers to hold whatever component I was working on at the time. With the tweezers holding the socket in place, I soldered one corner and double-checked the placement before soldering the rest of the pins. I did the same thing for the smaller sockets. Use the tweezers to hold the socket in place and solder one pin. Double check that it's flush with the board and solder the rest of the pins. Install the coin cell battery holder and use tweezers to hold it in place while you solder. Install the LEDs one lead at a time. Make sure it's flush to the board before soldering the other. Install the 7 segment displays. Pin 1 should be marked on the display, and the PCB has a square pad for pin 1. Use tape to hold them in place and solder one lead. Double-check the alignment is square before soldering the remaining leads. Attach short lengths of hookup wire to the tabs on the power deck. The third hand definitely helps hold everything in place while you solder. Attach the wires from the power jack to the PCB, and note that the power supply will be center positive. Attach 4 short lengths of wire to pads S2 and S3 that will be connected to the case-mounted switches later. Prepare the enclosure for the external components. Decide where you want to mount the switches, making sure that you have clearance from the PCB. Mark in pencil where you want to drill the 1/2-inch hole and the 5/16 hole for the power jack. Then get your drill.
Okay, so I finished assembling my clock, and now it's ready for code. And if you've already tried to plug yours in and nothing's happened, don't worry. The LED driver IC is in sleep mode, and we'll wake it up with the code. So go to jameco.com and go to the page for the kit. And then click on additional files to download the zip containing the necessary libraries and main code. And the current version of Arduino is 1.6 point something, but these libraries and code were written for the earlier 1.0 version, so you'll need to install the earlier version if you don't already have it. So here's the archive. I'm going to take the clock kit out for later, and here's the libraries. So copy those and then put them in the library folder for your Arduino. Okay. Then run Arduino. And the first thing we need to do is set the time on the clock. And we'll use that with the example from the DS1307 set time. And what this is going to do is calibrate the clock to the system time from your computer. So make sure your computer has the right date and time. And then get your USB to FTDI adapter. And since I didn't label this header, the DTR pin is closest to the capacitor there. So we'll plug her in. Make sure you have the right board for our Uno and the serial port. And upload it. So now that it has the right date and time, hopefully, we can use the clock code. And upload. Okay, so looks like it's working. This is the 12-hour mode. It looks like I have my buttons in backwards, so I'll have to fix that. Okay, so 12-hour mode. 24-hour mode with seconds, but we're still at 12 o'clock. There's the AM PM mode. There's the full date, April 18th, 2015. And there's the stopwatch, so that means this button. There we go. All right. Cool. So now you can close it up, and that's it. So tune in next time, and I'll show you how to add a temperature sensor and another mode for ambient temperature display. For more information, or to get your own, go to www.jameco.com/clockkit.